All right, so step two on this is going to be the dry brushing, okay? You need to make sure that you pick a dry brushing color scheme that's going to fit what you hope to do. And I'm going to give you a little example here. So we have here Mournfang Brown from Citadel, and we have a Gunkor Brow from P3. Now, these are both kind of a light brown. So I put them here. You'll see this is much more of a orange clay hue than this one is. Okay, and this goes along to your base. So as a base here, is this a clay hue, which means on the red side, or is it more on the green side? You know, which one is it going to be? You have to pick one. This plays, meaning the lighter colors, plays much more into the kind of vibrant, you know, fairy forest type of thing, and this much more into the dead type of, environment. So we're going to go with this one. So that means we need to pick a range that's going to fit that. Here, I would say, would be the next color up. This is XV88. So Mournfang Brown, XV88, and then you need to go really light Xandri Dust, okay? So there's your triad of colors, and I'm sure we all know how to dry brush, but just really quick, Mournfang Brown coming up first, and all right, first dry brush could be pretty heavy. Now you're not getting those bigger rocks, okay? You can kind of go around them. So this is hardly even a dry brush, to tell you the truth. It's more like almost a layer, but in fact, it actually is a dry brush because you're not getting everything. You want those crevices to still be the base color. All right, good. Let it dry for a moment. Clear some of that stuff off there. Without cleaning your brush, go right in for the next higher color. This one is going to be true dry brush, okay? So go ahead and get your brush proper. And we're going to come in. You're not going to notice much of a difference or a transition on this. It's only setting up so that your true highlight actually has something to mask into. Otherwise, it's going to be too big of a transition, okay? So there we go with that one. And then again, without cleaning the brush, going with the highlight color, the true highlight color. Okay, again. And there it is. Now, if you really want to get quite a bit brighter than that, you really want that GW type of highlight, okay? Do the same thing you just did, only come in with a little bit of white, okay? Take your highlight color, which is our Xandri Dust in this case, okay? Tap it, and then tap it in the white, and then basically you're kind of doing a dry palette, if you will, okay? And then come in and be very gentle with this stuff. Okay, and there is your highlight, okay, color. Now that's all done. Now we have to deal with those rocks before we start moving on to anything else. Again, you kind of have to pick between which one you want to go with. So here we have Great Coat Gray, and here you have Bastion Gray. Now you see that one is a little bit, this is almost like a brownish hue, and this is more of a straight gray hue, okay? I recommend going with the straight gray hue, especially since Azori has a lot of brown colors in it. And we're just going to paint the rocks really fast. I'm sure you guys all know how to do this. I don't need to belabor it too much, so I'm just going to zap through it real quick. Hopefully your rocks have been secured well in place. You want to ensure that they have been. Because if they haven't, you're going to dry brush these things as well. And they haven't, they're going to fly off when you start doing your dry brush. So just be aware. You'll see that I've missed stuff here in the crevice, and I've left some things not to the imagination, so to speak. But don't worry, there's tricks for getting rid of that as well and making it all nice. You don't need to do a particularly good job on this type of stuff as far as, you know, making sure it's totally coated and all that kind of stuff. Just get it gray. That's all you're really looking to do. You need a base coat of gray. All right? Fantastic. Now, I, generally speaking, don't start switching between a whole bunch of different types of gray. Some people go, well, now you go this gray, now you go that gray, et cetera, et cetera. Gray is kind of gray. So, yeah, sure, there are different types of it, but basically it's just black and white. So, therefore, you could really get away with just going in with a different type of color by using the same color, which means I'm just going to make sure your dry brush is clean. Take my gray coat, gray, and yep, that's right, you guessed it, white. Same thing. Now, because this is not a palette type of thing, I'm not worried about putting on this piece of construction paper here. I'm going to grab some white, and you want to come up quite a bit, okay? You see the difference between the two, that's about right. And once this is dry, which I hope it is, we're getting ready to do it, you want to very lightly dry brush those rocks, being careful not to get it on the rest of the base, which obviously is a brown color. And being careful not to go so hard that it flies right off. Now, essentially what this has done is just kind of lighten it up a little. So, and you can go back in. What I usually do is I dab it in white, okay? There's still enough gray on here to still tint it the right color. Again, very light brush strokes. All right, now if you really, really wanted to, you can do one more last highlight. So I just rub the dry brush off in my my rag that's over there, and then I'll just grab the white, and I'm kind of scraping against the edges. All right, remember, know when to stop. Very important part of this. All right, so now what we need to do is we need to get some grass in there. I'm going to pick some very green stuff. There's a little bit different technique for doing this. So what I do here is I'm going to take just our normal glue. Okay, I'll put a little bit down just on the paper here. What the hell? That's probably enough right there. I need to figure out why the thing is coming out of the side now. Interesting problem. Anyway, take your brush. Actually, you want something that has a little bit of a point to it, okay? So you can use whatever you like. I have some sculpting tools here that I haven't used for very much sculpting. Yeah, so I'm going to take this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it where, again, where is it barren and it really needs attention? So take a little bit of glue, and I'm going to put right there, so you can see, in that little hollow piece right there underneath that rock, right? So all on the base of that rock there. So that's one place for the grass, and let's go ahead and do the same thing here on this side and have it go around, because you probably can see there that I kind of screwed up and I dry brushed onto the brown a little bit. You don't need a lot, just a little bit. Don't go overboard. I think that's probably enough. So putting down grass, again, put it over your container, grab some, put it on, grab more than you think you need, and put more on, and then you're going to press it in. Be careful, because obviously you have the little rock right there. You don't want to tear it off. And there we are. And let's go ahead and do it right there as well. More than you think you need. Press. Obviously, this has to dry all the way, otherwise, static grass will stick to all the wet paint. you see? And if you ever look at it, you can still see a little bit of glue. Just go back in, press some down into it, and there we are. Now, one more, again, to really kind of make it flare, I guess we say, would be a tuft. And again, it's not required. You don't need to have it, but it is kind of a neat thing to do. What color should this be? It's really totally up to you. We have a very green tuft, but it's a different shade of green than the one that's already there. Because of the shade of this, kind of looks like deep forest, I'm going to go with one of these. This is a wasteland tuft here. Okay, it's like really dark. Because this, you know, I'm going to have miniature in the middle. I'm not going to go too big. I'm going to pick a medium-sized one here. Grab the top of the tuft, dip it in my glue. Make sure you get enough glue on it, okay? Including the little pieces if it has any runoffs. And I'm going to pick the spot wherever it is and put it down. Where white glue dries clear. And after 10 minutes of your time, there is the other base. There we are. So base type 1, we did this one. This was the very, very basic, you know, shoot through using flock and just kind of using pre-packaged and done items. And this is another larger one that was a little more involved. You'll see the difference between them. I would have to say, guys, that doing this type of base here, where it's a little more time consuming, but I think the results are quite a bit better than these other bases. Not that the materials are poor, because they really are wonderful materials, and they work really well, but for some reason, when you do it this way, it just turns out looking a little bit better. The other thing to remember on this, if you're doing these type of bases here, where you're just using the pre-made stuff, okay, and putting it down, remember that when you do it first, meaning you make the base first and then glue your miniature on top of it, the glue is actually going down on top of this material, okay? So like in this case, if I'm putting something down, I don't want to glue it to the material. I want, meaning the miniature, I want to glue the miniature to the base. So wherever his feet are, you actually have to come in. You're going to have to scrape it away so that whatever's left is solid enough for you to actually put your miniature down on, okay? Because if you just glue it to this stuff, it's only glued to the flock. And the flock's not very strong, and it's going to come off. Conversely, this stuff right here, because it's glued down, and if we put a lot of glue on top of it, a lot more, and we put paint on top of it, this stuff is pretty solid. And it's really going to take a pounding, and you can glue stuff directly to this. All right, so up to you. There's your choices right there. We're going to do another series on complicated bases where I'll use corkboard and pine bark. It's really kind of a different process when you're doing that, but a lot of these things for the more complex that we just did here are inside of a more complex base. So you have to understand how to do this first before you go to the more complex ones. All right, guys, again, thanks a lot. Hope you enjoyed. Leave a comment. Let me know if this helped or if I was speaking too fast or if it just don't make any damn sense in the first place. All right? Take care.